Chapter 4, The World of Metals and Non-Metals, Notes and Summary from Grade 7, Subject Science, Book Curiosity. Introduction. Yashwant and Anandi visit an ironsmith in their village to learn about metal work. They observe that metals like iron are used to make tools and utensils. Through this visit, they start discovering how different materials behave, especially metals and non-metals. Next, 4.1 Properties of Materials. 4.1.1 Malleability, the ability of a material to be beaten into thin sheets. Metals like copper, aluminium, and iron are malleable. Examples: aluminium foil, silver foil on sweets. Non-metals like coal and sulfur break when hammered. They are brittle. Holistic lens, history of iron. Iron was not used by Harappans, but later helped civilizations grow due to stronger tools. Iron helped improve farming, construction, and daily tools. 4.1.2 Ductility. Ductility, ability to be drawn into thin wires. Metals like copper, aluminium, and gold are ductile. Gold is very ductile. 1 gram can stretch into a 2 km wire. Non-metals like coal and sulfur are not ductile. 4.1.3 Sonority. Sonority, ability to produce a ringing sound when struck. Metals are sonorous, which is why bells and musical instruments use them. Non-metals produce dull sounds. 4.1.4 Conduction of Heat. Metals are good conductors of heat, used in cooking vessels. Wood is a poor conductor, so it's used for handles. 4.1.5 Conduction of Electricity. Metals allow electricity to pass through. They are good conductors. Materials like wood, coal, sulfur, plastic are poor conductors. That's why electricians use rubber gloves and plastic handles for safety. 4.2 Effect of air and water on metals. Iron. When iron is exposed to both air and water, it forms brown rust. Rusting damages iron objects and is a big issue in India. Prevention methods: painting, oiling, greasing, or coating with zinc, which is called galvanization. Next, the wonder of ancient Indian metallurgy. The iron pillar of Delhi, built over 1600 years ago, hasn't rusted, showing ancient India's advanced knowledge of metallurgy. 4.3 Effect of air and water on other metals. Burning magnesium in air forms magnesium oxide, a basic substance. Sodium reacts so strongly with water and oxygen that it is stored in kerosene. 4.4 Substances that behave differently from metals. Sulfur, a non-metal, burns in air to form sulfur dioxide, which creates an acidic solution. Non-metals like sulfur and phosphorus are brittle, dull, and non-sonorous, are poor conductors of heat and electricity, form acidic oxides. Phosphorus is stored in water because it catches fire in air. 4.5 Are non-metals essential in everyday life? Oxygen, needed for breathing. Carbon, found in all living things, essential for proteins, fats, and carbohydrates. Nitrogen, used in fertilizers for plant growth. Chlorine, used to purify water. Iodine, used as an antiseptic for wounds. Note, materials like plastic, glass, wood, etc. are not metals or non-metals. They are not elements. In a nutshell, summary: metals, lustrous, shiny, malleable, ductile, good conductors, form basic oxides, react with air and water, can rust, like iron. Non-metals, non-lustrous, not malleable, not ductile, poor conductors, form acidic oxides, usually don't react with water, don't rust. So friends, we have completed short notes and summary from chapter 4, The World of Metals and Non-Metals. We will do question answers of this chapter in a separate video. If you like the video, kindly like it and share it with your friends. Also, subscribe to my channel. We will meet in the next video. Thank you for watching.